It's really amazing how a short person he is, and how people don't respect him first, but amazing stuff he does in that book. When they hang him upside down and then they put in this really big coat, he can't actually escape from it, but he actually does escape, and it's really amazing and, you know, such a very interesting book.
I'm reading Rackham, and I appreciate it's an interesting historical novel. I haven't read enough to determine whether it's good or not, but it's pretty interesting.
Alright, so I have The Prince by Niccolo Machiavelli. It was written a long time ago, and it's basically how to rule a government. It explains a lot about Asian governments and modern governments, because it applies them, and it's really cool. I like it.
Okay, I have The Alchemist, and I find it interesting because I find one of the main characters' viewpoints that his denial of the truth to protect his prior knowledge interesting.
So this is New York State Department of Motor Vehicles Driver's Manual. I like this book because it teaches me how to drive and how not to not drive.
Okay, this is Nimona, and I like it because it shows someone who would normally be considered a villain in a different light, and I think it's really important for stories and really valuable in the story.
I'm reading Vegan Virgin Valentine, and I was supposed to say a quote, right?
Yes.
I think I remember this, he was searching for the perfect wave, she was searching for the perfect orgasm.
And I really like her work, and this is the only book of hers that I haven't read. And so far, I'm really enjoying different perspective on the other gender, which is, and other classical high school cliches.
So it's Ragtime, written by Dr. Rowe, and it's a different chapter. So the main basic thing about this is how immigrants suffer when they come to America, and how they have a difficult living in America.
So I'm reading Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban. It's the third part of it, and mostly I'm reading it because I feel it's a book you should read in your youth, and because my both roommates are really crazy about Harry Potter, and that kind of got me into it a little bit.
I'm reading Christopher Nolan's Lamb. It's about the gospel according to Christ's childhood pal. And I like that as a great modern comedy while it's talking about ancient times.
All right.
I don't think
I'm going
to say about it.
All right, you're not ready yet.
So I've got The Odyssey. I like how everyone says it's hard to read, but it's not.
This book is Bone, and I like it because it's a graphic novel.
Oh, I'm reading Shi Zongzui, it's a Chinese horror book, and I kind of like it because this kind of makes me realize something.
Go.
Okay, this is Ragtime, and I like it because it kind of teaches you in a story type way about the early 1900s, and I find
This is The Hate U Give, and I like it because it provides an interesting perspective on a shooting in a neighborhood that I wouldn't have had otherwise.
Nothing is everything and everything is nothing. Therefore, I am God.
I'm reading Ragtime, and it combines historical
figures with fictional characters to create a perfect image of the beginning of the 20th century.
I'm reading The Odyssey. I like how Odysseus is trying to find his way home after 20 years.
I'm reading Heart of Darkness, and I think it's interesting to read about someone who grew up in a time where maps weren't completely filled out in the world and the mystery of those places.
I'm reading Catching Fire, and I like the rawness of the writing that explains the nation's rebellion.
Cool, thank you.
This is Ragtime. I've read just the 15 first pages, and it was talking about Harry Houdini, the famous escape artist, and I've always liked these kind of things about escapism, so that's why I'm liking this book.
I am reading Homer's The Odyssey, and I really liked how they took past and ancient ideas into modern times, which gave it a really awesome perspective to read.
I really like this book because it's very nostalgic, and I grew up with these books, so...
That's cool.
Yeah.
What's it called?
The Lightning Thief.
This book is The Subtle Knife by Philip Pullman, and I like it because of its world building and also its social and religious commentary.
I am reading The Heart of Darkness by Joseph Conrad, and my favorite line so far is that they were conquerors, and for that you want only brute force.
I'm reading about The Heart of Darkness. This is about Joseph Conrad trying out to go to Africa.
In this article, there's something called behavioral sync, which is when the space of animals is invaded.
I'm reading The Beautiful Room is Empty, and I really appreciate the insight it's given me into the mindset of the 1950s.
Action.
I'm reading The Odyssey. The reason I like this book is because it is a Greek mythology book and it tells the story of a guy from Greece.
I'm reading Ragtime. We're doing that in doing humanities, and I like that book because I can understand without a dictionary.